From this moment on, you will now be known as Sharkbait.
Sharkbait! Ooh-ha-ha!
Welcome, Brother Sharkbait!
Sharkbait! Ooh-ha-ha!
Enough with the Sharkbait.
Sharkbait! Ooh! Bop.
Hey, what's up, everybody? This is D checking in with a much-requested update of the Frag tank that was started almost exactly a year ago. It was actually in February around Super Bowl time. But what was a Frag tank has greatly become another reef in itself. So I thought I'd walk you through the system and give you a little update. So here's a shot of the tank. It's basically a 20-gallon long, which I built in the filtration system myself. If you take a look on the side here, you'll see that I have it's dark there because I covered the lid. I have an all-enclosed overflow, which I built myself, and a simple system for filtering the water. Pads, I use carbon, which I don't run 24/7, but I run carbon or chemipure to keep the system filtered. Over here, I have my protein skimmer, which is currently not running. I shut it off. I do most of the nutrient export via water change. But for a tank this small, you can get most of your system parameters under control through the water change and closely monitoring the tank. So like I said, the tank is a 20 gallon long with about 3 gallons in the overflow section. I did the calculation. It's 3 gallon space in the overflow section, which makes it overall 17 gallon tank. And it's doing really good. I don't do any complicated dosing manually. You know, all I do is the two part maybe once every couple of weeks, because this tank is pretty self-sufficient. If you look at that, and I'll give you a close-up here, if you look at what this little chamber is, if you could take a good look at it, that is basically a breeder box, which I turned into a refugium. There's a section of Calerpa in there growing, and that does, I would say for this tank, that probably takes out about more than 75% of my nutrients. You see there's always algae in there. It grows over the edge. Let me give you a top view. The tank is screened in because I didn't want any of my buddies jumping. I took a great deal of the, not Calerpa, Chato, out of there yesterday because it'll grow over the side and literally I'll get pieces drifting in the tank. So I constantly cultivate it, and that is what takes care of majority of my nutrient export, is the algae growth. So it's doing what it's supposed to do, grow algae. The algae removes the nutrients. I started this tank with dry rock from Real Reef. Let me give you a little plug. Real Reef, their rock is responsible for the great growth, easy to attach to. One tip is, I'll say, when you put your rock in, I like to drill little holes in it with my drill, and over time your calcium and stuff will just bring that rock right to life. But yeah, I like to rough it up a little bit so it doesn't look painted or anything. And purple algae just grow on it and it'll look nice and natural. There's my urchin. I cleaned the tank out yesterday and he takes care of what I miss, my little pink urchin there. And the tank, like I said, is self-sufficient. I have easy to keep coral in here because what I do is I take whatever is overgrown in my tank upstairs and I bring it down here for grow out or for trade, or if people are starting a tank, I'll bring donations for my club and things down here for Brooklyn Aquarium Society. I'll bring things like that down here, and I also use this tank as a breeding ground for frags that I can't grow in the main tank. So yeah, it's funny, things that I can't grow upstairs, like SPS, I have a hard time upstairs, probably because of the fluctuation. The 150 gallon upstairs, well rather 125 plus the filtration upstairs. Down here I can grow a lot of things really quick and frag them and grow them really quick. So let's take a look at those pieces. All right, I've always tried to grow things like the chalice, and they're really easy to grow. And this pavona, This Pavona was a little piece, and if you look at it, you can see, you cannot even see the plug that I put in here. It's been in here about maybe I'd say 3 to 4 months, and it's grown right onto that real reef rock. Same thing with the chalice. Please look in my earlier videos. You will see that it was a little piece right past where that bump is. If you see that little bump, it was a piece, not even 2 centimeters. It is greatly encrusted onto the rock and is doing a great job of coloring up. I mean, really pretty piece. These little devil's hands, I have devil's hands all over the place. I just moved one, so that one's not happy because I just moved them. If you look at my earlier video, that is the big hand. You can see it's a bunch of bumps on it now because it's done a great job of growing. Here's another Pavona, and everything is surrounded by Kenya trees. If you know me, I love Kenya trees. They grow different in this tank than they do upstairs, probably because of the light. This is powered by an Arctic LED. The Arctic is a great light, full spectrum, the reds, blues, greens, whites, you know, do a great job of growing some coral. This tank is really, it's really self-sufficient, and it's just amazing. I don't know if you can catch it on here, but let me look at this piece here because this is closer to the camera. If you look at my prior video upstairs, you'll see that the Kenya trees can grow like a bush or they can grow straight up. These here typically grow in like a bush form. If you can compare it to like a maple tree, you have tall maples and then dwarf maples down here. They grow like dwarfs, really thick and bushy and round. And they're really pretty. I like them because they're easy for beginners, and I like to give people those as a starter coral. Here's another Pavona. Once again, you can't see the plug. The plug is gone. I glued that on with some regular crazy glue. Maybe I have some I can show you. Did I toss it? Oh, yeah, I have some. Let me fit down in my cabinet down here. Yeah, good old super glue. $1.50 at Deals. Does a great job. Just try not to glue your fingers together. While I have that open, I might as well show you the little station. Bionic, I really don't want to die. I don't dose this tank because, like, for a 17-gallon tank, if I tell you 1 milliliter would throw the pH straight up, then you don't have to dose it for a long time. Flakes I have down here, I crush those up into little dust particles, and I feed the corals, like the Xenia, I feed them little flakes at night when everything is sleeping. Aptasia, yep, I had Aptasia in the tank. And yes, it ended up down here. I have one there, which I'll be killing later. But even if you do everything right, I gotta stress, you will get pests in your tank. And waving hands here, way different than the pulsing zinnias. A lot of people, I hear them call the waving hands pulsing zinnias. Similar specimen, different growth rate, different piece. Excellent for beginners, and easy to cultivate, you know. You can get a little piece here. You'll see a piece. I've been trying to get it to attach to something, but they won't attach to this tile. I have pieces of tile. I have pieces of rock. They tend to attach to what they want. My zoas. Oh, yeah. I love those. I got this bush growing on here. It wasn't algae. Oh, look at that. Aptasia. Look at that. See what I'm talking about? That wasn't even there yesterday. I'll be killing that later. But once again, you just got to stay on top of it, and it'll be all right. But yeah, this bush. I thought it was pretty cool. And my Sally Blackfoot clowns, they're not tomato clowns, they look like tomato clowns. They have just taken to the zinnia. I mean, I put a lot of pictures on our site of those guys chilling at night. I guess I don't want to put an anemone in there because anemones will move and they will be a pain in the neck. Ask anybody, anemones, better to put them in there when you first start the tank, get them situated and then add your corals. But these guys love the zinnia. That forest of zinnia is so deep that when they swim in there, and there's 2 of them, maybe you'll see the other one. This is the male. They just get back in there. The male sleeps in there, and that started out as his bed. He used to sleep on that little rock sideways, but when the zinnia bush got really thick, he just took to sleeping in there. Hey, I see you. I see you. Where are you? Let me go over there. There they are, my male and female. They live behind that rock. I'm hoping that they breathe. I have this cleaner shrimp trained to eat out of this dish. When I walk up to the tank, he literally sits on that dish. he goes to the dish when I walk close to the tank and stays there. But yeah, everything is going good. So just an overview. Let me remove the cover here and give me a second. I want to add, I don't want to give you too much of a look, but this tank is currently powered by my fish bit controller, which is in prototype. You guys are going to see big things from the fish bit. The fish bit controller is controlling my lights, controlling my pumps. It's keeping the track of my salinity and pH. I don't want to give you too much of a shot because it's still in the prototype stage. May change, but I'm telling you, you guys are going to hear big things. Those of you who got hung up using the Neptune Apex and don't want to spend all that ridiculous amount of money, you have to keep adding on every month. I know because I have an Apex and I love it, so I'm not knocking it. But you guys are going to hear great things from Fishbit. So check out their website. Free plug, Fishbit controller. Doing a good job, fellas. Keep up the good work. My skimmer is not on. It's a Hydor skimmer. Got to put a call to Hydor because the pump died. I'm really let down that nobody emails me back or gets back to me. So this is running without a skimmer, which, since it's a nano, not really concerning to me. It's a small system. It was doing a great job, and then the pump just died, and I can't get anybody to answer me on the phone, so it is what it is. It is what it is. So this is the tank. What else do I have here? I got toadstool pieces here and there. I got my little hammer back there, a little torch back there. Everybody's a little frustrated because I moved them around. My clowns used to live over there, but since I guess that wasn't growing fast enough, they moved on to this other side. Here's some pollies here. Once again, they closed up because I moved everything around. Zoe's under the pressure of the killer. Was things like that really easy, but I thought I'd give you guys a overview and update of the tank. Focus, baby, focus. Yeah, easy. Easy peasy. There's my filter. Ooh, high tech. It's a pad. Regular pad. Anybody wants to know how to get a roll about that filtration pad? Keep your tank crystal clear like this? Nothing fancy, no filter socks. Check out the link below or just PM private message me. I sell that on eBay. Let me know if you need some. I get tons of it. I give you a really good price. And that's it. There's my filtration. I'm trying to hide the sun, so I want to show you the control. The spot there. There's my filter bag with my carbon in it. I alternate between the carbon and the Kimmit Pure because the Kimmit Pure is good for about 3 months. I don't leave it in there that long. That's it, man. Only fish in there are my Lamarck's wrasse, which I probably have to throw some food in there to get him out because he's pretty funny about that stuff. Let me see. Come on, bub. Maybe it'll come out. Okay, and that's it. That's the tank, people. 2 clownfish, 1 shrimp, 1 wrasse. And it's doing good, so I want to take this opportunity to thank you guys for subscribing. I hit that 600 mark, which is totally awesome. I love posting you guys' videos and checking out you guys' videos. Reshare. Oh, there he is. Reshare. Send me your links. I love to subscribe to your channels. I got my smart TV, 60 inches, baby, so I can watch YouTube straight on the big screen in HD quality. Check it out. Send me a note below. Ask any questions you want. And until next time, thank you for watching. Check us out, Brooklyn Aquarium Society or DFB Aquatics on Facebook and Instagram. Till next time, this is D signing out. See ya. There he is. Don't be shy. You're a Brooklynite.